live from Midtown Manhattan, Madison Square Garden. And inside the garden at the Felt Forum, some 3,000 fans, team representatives, and 18 of the best basketball players in the world ready to begin their NBA career are here with us this afternoon at noon Eastern time from New York City. Hello, everybody. I'm Bob Neal. Here's the order of selections in the first round today. The top three teams were determined in order by the draw at the lottery. The top seven were the lottery teams, but after the first three, the rest of the teams will draw in order of the way they finished and their record in the NBA last year. And they start with the Los Angeles Clippers, and you see that 8 and 9 were Charlotte and Miami. They determined who would go first, also by a coin flip. And down through 16 were the Houston Rockets, and of course the two-time world champion Los Angeles Lakers will be selecting 25 teams, two extra teams in the draft this year.
For the first selection in the 1988 NBA draft, the Los Angeles Clippers select Danny Manning of Kansas.
Selection, he's 22 years old, 6'11", 220 pounds, two-time consensus All-American, and of course remembered best, I'm certain, for his 1988 NCAA tournament play against Oklahoma. He was the tournament MVP in that game, 31 points, 18 rebounds. He did it all, took the game in his hands, and literally led Kansas to the national championship. The all-time leading scorer in Big 8 conference history with nearly 3,000 points, Danny Manning going for the Los Angeles Clippers.
Danny, you were a great player always at Kansas, but in the NCAA tournament, your game just went to a new level. What did you do, and how did you become an even better player?
Well, I think, we started off the season. We had a lot of talent on the team. We lost some players. We were 12-8 at one point in the season, and things looked real bleak for us, but we came together and played as a team.
No surprise you're taken by the LA Clippers, but you haven't signed a contract yet. I know that's not your big worry. It's your agent, but when do you want to get signed? When do you want to get that part of your life over with and start playing pro ball?
Well, hopefully we can get it done as soon as possible without many hassles. You know, just want to go in there, see a nice contract that we like, sign, and get down to business.
You're used to winning ball games from high school to college. We won a national championship. What adjustments is it going to be going to a team that has been struggling?
Well, it's going to be adjustment, you know, but I have to go in, and I'm going to go out and play as hard as I can every night, and that's the best I can do.
Well, congratulations. Also, congratulations to your father, Ed, who's watching down in San Antonio.
For the second pick in the 1988 NBA draft, the Indiana Pacers select Rik Smits of Marist College.
Located about 60 miles southeast of Amsterdam. He started playing basketball when he was 14. By the way, if you wonder about his discipline, you know he's a well-disciplined youngster. His father is 6'7 and is a former European judo champion. So I doubt at 7'3 if Rik Smits ever returned any compliments to his father. He played at Marist, and of course a lot of people wonder if the competition at Marist was enough to get him ready for the banging, the physical nature, and the intensity of the 100-plus games in the NBA that he'd have to play, counting preseason and playoff games.
And here's the hat you can put on. Now a member of the Indiana Pacers. A big pick for Indiana. We had him listed earlier a year ago, maybe at 7'2", now 7'3". You tell me you're still growing?
Oh, yeah, I'm about 7'4".
7'4". A lot of the players out here today, it's been a lifelong dream to play in the NBA. When did you first decide that, hey, it is a chance and that's what you really want to do with your life?
Well, the sophomore year in college, I decided. You know, we played in the NCAA tournament, and I think our team did pretty well. And then I saw the NBA as a possibility for me.
You're going to Indiana. Did you ever see the movie Hoosiers?
Oh, yeah. Nice movie.
Okay. Thanks a lot for being with us.
For the third pick in the draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select Charles Smith of the University of Pittsburgh.
Smith from the University of Pittsburgh. Charles Smith is 6'10", 225 pounds. A lot of scouts think he may be better suited for a small forward than a power forward role. He likes to go outside a little bit. He is a definite major projection in this draft. Everybody likes him, but once again, not the man that people thought Philadelphia would take, indicating that Roy S. Johnson and the stories we've heard is that this man may be selected for a later deal to be made in the draft. But Charles Smith is going to be playing and playing.
Smits was very excited to put on his Indiana Pacer hat, but Charles Smith is a little bit tentative about putting on your Philadelphia hat. I saw you stop by the LA Clippers table. What's happening?
Well, there's been some whispers about a trade, and whatever happens to me, I'm pretty much up in the air for it, and take the situation as it comes. I think probably the better situation for me would be in Philadelphia, due to the fact that I'm from the East and Pittsburgh's in Pennsylvania, and I think I can get the fan support from Philly.
But if you go to the Clippers, you'll be teamed with Danny Manning. I know when you play in the summer camps and go, they always split you two up.
Yeah, that's a great situation. Danny and I are pretty similar players, and we would like to get on the floor and run a lot, and we can do different things and play an up-tempo type game. So that's also a great situation.
Well, hold on to that hat. You may be wearing another one before the day's over. Back to Bob Neal.
For the fourth pick, the New Jersey Nets select Chris Morris of Auburn.
Chris Morris is 6'8", 210 pounds from Auburn University. He's a native of Atlanta, Georgia, was second in the SEC in both scoring and rebounding. He is a tremendous player, a real athlete, and I always get a kick out of calling an NBA player an athlete. I haven't known many who haven't been, but by that means he can leap, he can run, he can shoot, he can do about anything. Some people say they remind him, certainly is a long way from that, but almost the kind of skills that a Dominique Wilkins might have in the NBA.
For the fifth pick in the draft, the Golden State Warriors select Mitch Richmond of Kansas State.
Oh, that's a good one.
Mitch Richmond, one of Larry Connolly's favorite players in this draft. 6'5", 225 pounds, fourth leading scorer in the Big Eight on a ball control team, by the way. He was a second team All-American. Played 2 years at Moberly Community College. He was a JUCO All-American. And from Kansas State comes Mitch Richmond. And Larry, tell us why you like this young man so much.
Bob, the thing I like about him is that he does everything very well. He's a fierce competitor. He likes to get the basketball in clutch situations. He plays well in the big games.
A lot of people thought that maybe he'd go a little bit later in the first round. Was it a surprise you're going to Golden State?
Oh, yes, it is a big surprise. I thought they'll go with the big rebound, the big shot blocker, but it's a surprise.
Two of the first five picks are from the Big Eight Conference. Says a lot for the Big Eight.
Yes, it is. It shows that we have great talent in the Big Eight, too.
For the sixth pick in the draft, the Los Angeles Clippers select Hersey Hawkins of Bradley.
There is Hersey Hawkins. He's 6'3", 200 pounds. He went to Westinghouse High School in Chicago, Illinois, National Player of the Year honors from several prestigious groups like Associated Press, UPI, Sporting News, Consensus All-American, a great player and a great scorer. He played at the same high school as Mark Aguirre, Westinghouse in Chicago. And Hersey Hawkins, interestingly, Larry Connolly, I heard, I chuckled at this because he's 6'3 and a tremendous complete player.
For the seventh pick in the draft, the Phoenix Suns select Tim Perry of Temple University.
Tim Perry is 6'9", 200 pounds from Temple. Freehold, New Jersey is his hometown. He was the MVP in all tourney at the Orlando Classic. And Larry Connolly, he's one of the players who really moved up in the eyes of a lot of scouts when he played at that tournament of the graduating seniors of the available players down at Orlando.
Bob, you know, the NBA runs three camps prior to the draft. One is in Portsmouth, Virginia, one in Orlando, and then the big one in Chicago. I was in Orlando to watch Tim Perry play, and I thought he played as well as anybody down.
For the eighth pick in the draft, and their first in the NBA, the Charlotte Hornets select Rik Smits of Kentucky.
After his sophomore year, Rik Smits, just 21 years old, in this coming October. He is a 6'4.5 guard, 185-pound guard, Rex Chapman, has been selected as the first draft choice ever by the Charlotte Hornets.
Ninth pick in the draft, and their first in the NBA, the Miami Heat select Ron Cicely from Syracuse University. The next selection belongs to the San Antonio Spurs.
So Ron Cicely becomes the first big man to go since Manning and Smits went 1-2 and then Charles Smith. Three of the first eight selections in this draft have been big guards, but now a big man, Ronnie Cicely, 6'11", 240, hometown Athens, Greece. At Syracuse University. He was a four-year starter at center there.
For the 10th pick in the draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Willie Anderson of Georgia.